it's time to make your vote count in one of the most important events of the year, the Australian federal election.
Is this not about Eurovision?
Listen, they're both examples of democracy at its finest.
Is it a coincidence that they're both in the same month? Of course. Is one more important than the other?
Will I be using it to explain how to vote? Yes, of course.
So here's how to vote in the Australian federal election, Eurovision edition. When you arrive to the polling station on election day, you'll be given two ballot papers. One will be green, that's for the House of Representatives, and a large white one for the Senate. Now the green one is to decide who your local MP will be. That's the person to represent your area in Parliament, much like we're deciding who will be the winner of Eurovision. You'll number the candidates in the order of who you want to represent you, from first choice to last. So I'm going to go Australia, one, because I want them to win the most, second, Ukraine, three, Moldova, four, Azerbaijan, and five, UK, because they're the country I least want to win.
Now, it's important to remember to put numbers in all of the boxes on your ballot paper when you're voting, because Australia uses the preferential voting system.
Under the system, candidates need more than 50% of the vote to be elected. So if my first preference is knocked out because they're nowhere near that, my vote goes to my second preference. This goes on and on until your vote counts for one of the top two candidates. Now, that's just for the green paper. When it comes to the huge white paper for the Senate, there's even more to unpack.
I'm not sure this Eurovision analogy will work here, but much like the Brits, I should give up, but I won't.
The large white paper is to decide who will represent your state or territory in the Senate. Let's imagine it's another Eurovision competition. Each state has 12 senators, but the ACT and the Northern Territory only get two each. Often, lots of people, or bands to continue this analogy, are running for the Senate, which is why it can often end up looking like this. With this paper, you can vote above or below the line. Voting above the line means you're voting for which party you want in the Senate. So you want Ukraine first this time, then Australia, and then Moldova. But if you go below the line, you can decide the order of candidates you want to see in the Senate. So you won't be voting for each party, but rather each candidate. In Eurovision terms, it means I wouldn't be voting for each country or group, but rather for each band member.
Is this analogy getting tiring yet?
Now remember, you don't have to wait until election day to cast your vote. Early voting polls are already open, so head down now to get in early.